Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have hit the coast of the most ruthless and fearless ghost of Christmas of all. We are going to find out if Pencilneck is going to change his life around, and the lives of his henchmen. The only way is to discover this madness.
What's up, bitch? Well, speaking of holy shit...
I told he would shit his pants, but if you peeps knew it all along, then good for you.
Shit! I got shit smeared all over my fucking ass.
Hello, Boris the Pencil Neck Cockroach Television Head. I am the ghost of Christmas future.
Oh my god! What kind of a ghost are you?
Well, let me tell you this. I am one of a kind of a ghost who will have the guts to show your puny little asshole red teeth self what the fucking fuck is gonna happen if you continue to cause more bullshit drama and various crimes.
If what continues?
I say, you puny weakling, is that you also committed racial remarks against people due to their stereotypes and colors of their skins, saying everything offensive to God and Jesus Christ.
Fuck you, fuck God, and fuck Jesus. Ouch! What the fuck was that for?
See that, you Christ-defying son of a bitch? You're the main reason why you have done everything that is wrong. I hope the Lord of Christ will thunder strike your sorry ass back to hell. Little boy, it's time for you to pay for hurting that bird, not going to church, and staring at boobs every day.
Bullshit. Religion is a fucking... What is wrong with you, whore?
I'm telling you, pencil Satanist. You keep doing what you always do, especially offending Jesus, you will be trapped to the lake of fire for all eternity.
Oh, I've been burned before in my life. When I die,
it's about to get worse if you don't change. Now come with me.
I bet his predicted future will be a lot worse, way worse than Mason and the rest of you viewers think. So time to proceed.
What the hell? Why are we back at this bullshit police department?
This is the final destination, aka on the road to next and last Christmas.
Well, what does this have to do with me and the last Christmas?
Follow me, you cock muncher, I'll show you why.
You would realize that this one is about to get ugly as pencil next teeth, right? Yeah, it's all fucked up.
What in the fucking hell is this catastrophe?
Take a good look of yourself and that oppressed format of Santa Claus.
Ugh, this turkey and those sides and appetizers taste like shit!
This is a big ass mistake that those pigs pulled on us.
I hope we'll have our revenge on those fucking puny weaklings on the next life.
I'll tear them limb by limb and avenge you and those good for everything teeth clowns alone if you can't escape from hell.
Why are my future self and Satan Claus in jail for and dressed up like shit?
You and Satan Claus got arrested last year, remember?
Damn, this still means my henchmen are dead, right?
That's right, bitch. Mason and Coda killed them and the policewoman brought the SWAT team to place you and Satan Claus to execution at this year at midnight.
Oh, god damn it, I can't watch.
Well, I can. Let's go straight to 5 minutes before the execution to you and Satan Claus.
So, Pencil Neck, any last words before we put you down for good?
I really want to say is that I curse the original bastard who got me to look miserable from the grave. That original bastard is Gay Lou Anderson, and I had a good life until he fucked it all up, the shitter on the count of him and various people around, and I also blame it on God for defying me like a plague for giving me a fucked up life.
Satan Claus, anything else to say before we put you down for good?
My last words are the same thing as Boris the Teeth Guy's comment. But I personally blame every one of you all naughty little nitwits for not listening to Boris the Teeth Guy or his henchmen. I mostly blame Santa Claus for not showing what Christmas is all about but is inspired by Futurama, and I also curse him from the grave.
Goodbye for good losers.
We're glad it's over.
Have fun in the lake of fire.
See y'all never, you Satanists.
Alright, start the execution, now.
Oh my god! Please tell me this ain't true. Please, for the love of the red teeth bandits, tell me none of this is fucking true.
If you don't change your fucking ways by the time Christmas has started, everything you have ever done so will be true.
No, I don't want this to happen.
Cry, baby.
Don't make fun of me crying, but please, I can change. I can change my ways right away before I make my life worse than ever.
No, you must die. Face your worst fucking nightmare, bitch.
No, no, no.
Wake up, pencil fucking neck.
Get the fuck away from me, damn.
Snap out of it, dumbass. I just want to remind you that instead of staying in jail for the rest of this year, you will be having the next 2 months of probation.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah, you better not think of anything stupid, alright?
Good.
Now that Pencil Neck is out of jail, he has decided to go see Santa to ask him bringing his henchmen back to life. I don't know if this will happen.
Hi, Santa.
Oh, it's that good for nothing Boris the Pencil Neck Teeth guy.
Look, Santa, I don't ask for anyone's forgiveness, but what I want for Christmas is to have my red teeth friends back to life and have my Plotagon logic skills back.
Well, alright. Time to make your wish come true with Plotagon logic.
Well, looks like Pencil Neck has finally done it. He is bringing back his good-for-nothing henchmen and his Plotagon logic skills. This is brings out the Christmas miracle. Wait a fucking minute, why the hell am I reading this? This is the fucking ending that's rubbish, inflammatory, and brutally inappropriate.
Hey there, Orion.
Hey, Mason. Care to explain this?
Oh, that fucking Red Teeth Christmas Carol book. This isn't the version we ordered.
Go ahead and burn the son of a bitch. Who is it?
Hello, Mason. Hi, RTada. How are you? Not too much, because some dickhead switched packages between yours and the Pencil Neck gave you in CyberPod the wrong version of the Red Teeth Christmas Carol book, right? Damn! Right, Pencil Neck gave us that book with the most NSFW inappropriate ending for the teeth clowns that they wanted, and newsflash for those jerkoffs because I burned them. Here's the same book with the greatest ending. Yes! Thanks, RTada, and Merry Christmas. You're welcome, Mason. Merry Christmas to you too, and Happy Kwanzaa. We got the same book with the best ending.
Thanks, Mason. You and RTada truly saved Christmas with this book. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we're back on air with the same book, but with the most memorable ending that you'll ever get to see. So when Santa Claus heard Pencil Neck's wish, he almost made it come true with one sudden movement that ruined his chance.
Well, alright. Time to make your wish come true with Plotagon logic.
That settles it.
Hey, Pencil Neck.
Who is that?
Jehovah's Witnesses.
Stupid fucking motherfucker, I can't believe that you left me in the forest to let me die after you and your henchmen beat me up.
What the fuck you talking about?
Oh, Pencil Neck, what is the matter with you? I can't believe that you and your henchmen kidnapped Jin Saotome and beat him up at the forest.
Fuck you, Santa, you are grounded for denying my damn wish that I deserve.
Shit!
Even though killing someone is naughty, but I had no choice.
Don't worry about it. Since you came back but you still feel the pain, what do you want for Christmas?
Well, Santa, all I want for Christmas is Pencil Neck and his henchmen suffer in hell for all eternity, their Plotagon logic skills disabled for good, and bring back harmony and peace.
That's a good wish, Jin. So it is granted.
Ugh, what the hell is wrong with those people?
Oh man, what is their problem?
Time to be stoned with lumps of coal.
The flaming lumps of fucking coal.
No!
No.
Finally, Christmas is here.
Let's go open our presents.
Oh, Emily, we finally got a new 69-inch TV.
I know, sweetie. Get ready for the best quality that is too good to miss.
We're glad that Pencil Neck and Satan Claus are forever gone.
Yeah, there's no way to see them again. Best Christmas ever.
Thanks for wishing us to have peace and harmony just in time for Christmas.
It wouldn't have happened if Santa Claus wasn't here, but thankfully it did, so no problem.
There you all have it, peeps. Pencil Neck will never change his ways, for what he did was wrong.
We're glad that you told the story of Pencil Neck and he's back in hell.
I couldn't have done it without you or anyone else. Want to go to Mason's house to have a Christmas party?
I love to. Let's rock our heads off.
Now let's rock and roll.